bro. Welcome to the video and happy Thanksgiving. Today's kind of like, it's kind of like the day of gains, if you know what I'm saying. Today I got a special video planned for y'all because we are here with the one and only Jesse James West.
Yo, it's just Jesse for you.
It just flows so naturally. Jesse James West.
What's up, guys? Hope you're having a great day.
What's funny is we're the only two people I know who work with Transparent Lab supplements. Well, I guess us and the mountain.
Thor,
the mountain. We're not on his level. Like, let's be honest.
He's a bit big.
He's a large man. He was in Game of Thrones.
Yeah.
I would love to be. If we're in Game of Thrones one day, we've made it.
Dude, I could see you on it easily. You got the tats. You got the beard going.
I don't think they had tats.
I mean, they could just add it in, CGI it or something.
Good work. By the way, how old are you, bro?
20.
Wait, like 20?
Yeah, I'm only 20.
For real?
Yeah.
Honestly, I would have guessed you were like 24. And like, I'm not trying to pump your tires, bro.
24?
Yeah, but it's kind of impressive how much you've accomplished and like how much action you take and what type of videos you produce being 20 years old.
Thank you, man. That actually means a lot to me coming for you. You produce the highest quality stuff on YouTube.
Well, that means a lot. That means a lot to me coming for you.
It's good.
It's like when I was 20 years old, I was in college. I think it was beginning of my senior year, and I was doing anything I could to like avoid thinking about the future. I just wanted to play video games, drink a lot, and not too much else. It's like, I'm impressed, bro.
Thank you. Appreciate that.
I think right there.
That's good. All right, there now that we got the good angles, I'm curious to ask you, I think y'all be curious too, what do you think you're doing differently than the average 20-year-old? Because I'm sure you have a lot of friends who just, you know, they're just trying to have fun. Like, specifically, what have you done differently?
I mean, when I first started, it was pretty much, I was making these lacrosse videos, I was going to school, studying for communications, and I decided to look at myself of where I was and where I wanted to be, and then what steps I need to take to get there.
So you were studying communications, like what was your plan? What did you think you were supposed to do? What do you think you were going to do?
So like the plan was, I was supposed to be maybe a social media or marketer for another company.
So just trying to get hired and get a job. But when you looked at yourself, you're like, what do I actually want to do? You're like, I kind of want to build my own social media platform around lacrosse.
No, so I was making lacrosse videos, but truly at heart, I wanted to be making fitness content.
So you're saying that you were here at point A and you wanted to get to point B, you know, making your own YouTube content, but really the path you were taking going to school was taking you over here to point C.
Exactly.
So like, what did you do specifically to course correct and start going to that real goal?
The exact moment was through a ton of self-reflection and then realizing that if I want to get from point A to point B, I had to drop out of school, and I took action on that. It was very scary and risky, but it's something that I knew, like, if I wanted to get to where I wanted to be, I had to do it.
Yeah, that's a big step. But guys, we're not recommending that you drop out of school, but obviously in your case, it became clear it's not gonna be easy, but that's what I gotta do. Here's a question. Is what you're doing right now going to get you where you want to be? If it is, that's awesome. But if not, like, you have to course correct, and it's not always easy. When I was working my software engineering job and decided I want to do personal training, I was so afraid what other people were going to think, my parents and my friends, that I didn't even tell people for a few months. And when I did, you know, luckily my parents were supportive. You might be surprised. They still didn't really understand it, but I faced like a lot of snarky comments from people at work when I was telling them that I'm quitting, or my friends that were like, you're gonna be a personal trainer? Like, do you know how much money you're giving up? And it's tough to get past that resistance, right? Like, I think most people, that's what stops them from course correcting. So like, what did you do to overcome the external resistance?
I literally just stopped caring about what other people thought, and it was really difficult to do that. You know, it's easier, much easier said than done. But the second that you just get tunnel vision and stay relentless, you know, you can reach so many bigger goals in life than you could ever imagine.
Yes, this idea of self-validation that I'm always talking to y'all about. It's not easy, but at the end of the day, and this is something that you should do every night, ask yourself, is what I did today cool? Like, am I proud of what I did? And if the answer is yes, then it doesn't matter if Julie or Jesse thinks it was cool. David thought it was cool, and that's good enough for me.
Lately, I've been living like I can't take a loss.
Alright, so tomorrow's Black Friday, and I know y'all are probably gearing up to find the best deals. So first of all, the Edge Black Friday launch, it already went live on Monday, so everything on the website, including the brand new items, like these joggers, this bomber jacket, this t-shirt, everything's up to 70% off. Link in description if you want to check that out. But a lot of y'all have been asking, what about the Beastly app? Are you gonna do something for the Beastly app? If you're not familiar, the Beastly app is the best fitness app in the game. 100% custom workouts and meal plans. It literally adapts based on your body type and your experience level. And right now, we're running a super special deal. You can get your entire first month for $1. After that, it will go up to the normal monthly price, which is a super good deal anyway. This is only gonna be valid for new members who haven't joined the app yet, but now's the perfect time to hop in if you've been waiting, man. First link in description, go check it out.
Anything else besides the pasta?
So for the post-workout gains, we're at this spot called Piada, Italian street food. If you've been faithful to the channel, then you know I've been here once before. I got a pasta with a bunch of good stuff. But I'm curious because
bro.
Jesse's a real Italian.
Bro, do you see? Oh, okay.
Take a bite, let us
taste
know.
Taste
test? Score out of 10. That's, you gotta have the score out of 10.
Oh, out of 10? Let's see. Magnifico. I give it a 8.7.
Dude, I don't even need an out of 10. That's enough. Enough said.
Yeah, honestly, the that's enough.
This place is, it's like an Italian Chipotle, and it's for sure
heaven.
It's gonna be one of my go-to spots in Houston, no doubt.
Dude. Yo, so I got a question for you now.
What's up?
You're 31, right?
31.
So if you were to look back in your 20s, what's one mistake you learned from the most?
A mistake in my 20s, something yeah. I would change.
Yeah.
All right, so I don't know if this is something you're doing because like we just met today.
That is true.
But something that for sure held me back was I was always trying to impress other people. Like, y'all know I used to suck with girls, right? And I think maybe the core reason for that is I wanted to impress my other guy friends. So, you know, whenever, once in a blue moon when I hooked up with a girl or a girl would text me, I'd be like, bro, this girl won't stop texting me. Oh man, guys, I had a crazy night last night with this girl. You wouldn't believe it. And because of that, you know, because I couldn't admit that I sucked with girls to my friends, it would have been, it just would have felt weird for me to be like reading dating advice or going out and trying to practice talking to girls. Yeah, so I never did that stuff and then I never got better.
So personally, I can relate to that because in the past, in previous relationships with girls, I actually struggled with trying to please them too much.
So like, what would you do to please a girl you were with?
So she would not want me posting shirtless selfies or shirtless videos, and obviously that's what I do, so I just stopped doing it.
So like if you posted one, she would just like get mad at you or be passive aggressive.
Yeah. So it caused a lot of issues between us in our relationship, but yeah, I would cater that to her and I shouldn't have done that.
So here's my challenge for you, man. Right now, ask yourself, what is the number one thing in your life that you're kind of ashamed of? Maybe it's that you suck with girls while your friends have girlfriends and they're getting laid. Maybe it's that you're kind of broke, but you feel pressured to portray this image of success because your friends are successful. And then the next step, once you've identified this thing, is to just like fucking like stop putting up this front. You know what I mean? Admit to your friends, like, guys, I gotta be honest with you. I kind of suck with girls. It's something I need to work on. Because first of all, people are gonna be more accepting than you think. And if they're not, then they probably shouldn't be your friend in the first place. But beyond that, once you let down that front, now you're gonna be free to actually, you know, read dating advice. Go out and try talking to girls without worrying what other people think. Because other people know the reality. You're gonna be free to focus on saving your money and paying off your debt rather than feeling pressured to lease the newest BMW. So on one hand, it frees you to actually start working to improve yourself. But on the other hand, like when you meet someone who's okay with the fact that they suck at some things, like if you meet someone that's like, oh, I'm going out tonight to try and approach some girls, immediately you're gonna recognize like, damn, this guy's fully comfortable with himself. Like he doesn't need other people to think he's perfect.
Yeah, vulnerability just establishes confidence and that's just gonna translate to being an alpha.
Yeah, man, when you meet someone like that, immediately you're like, oh, this person's not like other people. This guy's a boss.
Am I a boss? Back again like flu season, I broke records while loose leafing. I'm coming now, my roof leaving, don't give a fuck, I don't care. Did the shit by my lonesome, no wonder now I'm on one. No shortcuts on that long run, all I really want is my share. Get on my god, on my tongue.
Bro, do you know where we're at right now? Julie, tell them where we're at.
At our new house.
This is the crib, this is the casa. Do y'all remember what this looked like last time we were here? It was not even a month ago. Like it's insane how fast this went up. I don't wanna spend this whole video talking about this because that's not what this is about. But like, we have a home. They just finished the home. We have a driveway. Should we give them a sneak peek of the inside?
I don't know, should we? How do you open this door? Okay, no, really no.
Let me see. Yeah. It's a man's job.
Ooh.
Ooh. It lights up. All right, go first.
Are you ready?
First.
Are you ready for this? Oh my God! Look at this floor.
Yo, this is. This is beautiful, bro.
I'm like speechless. Wait, why aren't the appliances in? Isn't everything supposed to be done?
So, they told us, all right guys, so check it out. These countertops are amazing, but they had actually put in the wrong countertops. We didn't tell you guys about it, it was such a headache. They finally replaced these, but because of that, they had to delay putting in, I mean, I guess they put the sink in, but they had to delay putting in like the stovetop and the, I can't talk, the vent hood, because they had to replace the countertops, but then I guess the appliances were backordered. Also, the appliances are the built-in microwave and oven, but they told us it was gonna be done. And we're supposed to move in a couple days, but
it's just not gonna pass.
I mean, this place is insane, don't get me wrong, but they said it won't pass inspection without the appliances, so. I mean, I don't want to get too off topic, but stay tuned for the next video. I'm not sure if we're moving in yet. So throughout this video, myself and Jesse, we shared a couple major mistakes that we've made in our 20s. And there's one more big one that I want to share with you guys. And that's that I was never willing to take one step backwards in order to leap three steps forward. All right, this is something I've mentioned to y'all before, but you really have to be willing to take the short-term L to get the long-term W. You know, dating for a long time, I didn't want to face rejection, so I never made progress. But once I put myself out there, I took a lot of L's, a lot of short-term rejection, but that's ultimately what I needed to do to build the confidence to be successful with girls in the long term. Same thing with my career. You know, I quit my personal training job and left a good salary. And I was so afraid that I didn't do that for a long time. I didn't want to take that out. I didn't want to take that step backwards. But once I did it, then I tried personal training and I tried a bunch of other things that eventually gave me, you know, the skills I needed to build a successful YouTube channel. But it only happened because I could take that one step back, ultimately to launch myself three steps forward. And the same thing could be said, and I don't talk about this a lot, but my second girlfriend I was with, it was a very toxic relationship. But I was comfortable in it, I was attracted to her, we were both into fitness, I thought it's what I wanted, and because of that, I clung to it for a long time when I knew that it wasn't good for me. We'd break up, we'd get back together, and I just, you know, I was complacent, I was comfortable in it. But ultimately, after about a year, I made the call to break up with her because I knew it's what was best for me. And it hurt, for months it was painful, I wanted to be back with her, I had to take that step backwards. But ultimately, once I recovered from that, I had such a more confident mindset talking to girls and dating girls after that. No longer was I needy and needing to be with someone. It's like I had got rid of that neediness, even though I had to give up someone I thought I wanted to be with and deal with a lot of pain in the short term. What I'm saying, man, is right now, if there's something you've been avoiding doing because you feel like you're gonna be taking a step back in life, that probably means it's something you should do, and it's probably gonna be necessary for long-term growth, even if it sucks in the short term. That all being said, I'm gonna wrap this video up here. If you're still watching, give it a thumbs up. If you're new to the channel, go ahead, click subscribe and turn notifications on, because I drop two new videos every single week and you don't want to miss them. I will talk to all of y'all in the next video. I'm not sure if we'll be moved into our house or not. Stay tuned and stay beastly. Let's go crazy, my baby, dancing with the lights. Together we could chase the sun.